Outside across the Bay Area, great day to get outside for some 4th of July fun. Although, as Dob pointed out, it was warm in Concord but freezing in San Francisco. So the question is the fog going to play ball when it comes to those big fireworks shows? Here is meteorologist Aaron Peck with the answer.
And Brian, as you well know, this is only classic July weather. It's a whole different world here at the Golden Gate Bridge than it is near Concord where Dob was for that fire. The clouds that are being driven onshore here are part of the winds that are then going up through the Delta and making it windy through the passes. If you look at how widespread that cloud is right now, that's your classic marine layer along the coast. There it is, hanging out at the Golden Gate. And if we put it into the future cast, watch the way this plays out over the next few hours. And this is what it's done almost exactly for the last four nights. By the time we get to 9 o'clock tonight, the marine layer is back into the immediate bay. And if we look at a close-up view here, the city will certainly be blanketed. But if you just go over the hill, there's another fireworks show that's gonna be happening in Pleasant Hill. And you can see the marine layer stops at this point anyway in the East Bay Hills. It'll get cloudy for everybody overnight. But by 9:30, it should still be clear over here. I'll be back with the rest of our forecast.
On the other hand, tonight, they may not make much of a splash close to the coast either, Darren.
No, that's why there are two fireworks shows going off tonight for the Bay Area. Either of them will be great, but the one in the city is likely going to have an issue with clouds. The one over in Pleasant Hill, you should be fine. And we went into a lot of detail on that at the top of the newscast, but there's your summary. I want to focus on what I think is now going to become the headline in the forecast after we get through the holiday, which for the most part, we've already covered the weather for that in the forecast, and you've already lived it. Look at the red bullseye now in the long-range forecast. So this is 6 to 10 days. So this is towards the end of the 7-day and then going out several days past that. The higher the degree of confidence, the deeper the shade of red that temperatures are gonna be above average. And we gotta start re-gearing ourselves now. We have had fantastic weather for like the last 2 weeks here in the Bay Area. You've seen national news of record-breaking heat waves to our north and to our east, and we've been okay. We've had our typical June gloom and now no sky July. And if that's the biggest of our problems, we should count ourselves lucky. Let me show you how this is gonna change. What would be average for inland parts of the Bay Area this time of year would be 88. Watch the line. So we'll go, I'm starting it on Tuesday, by the way, because we're still a little ways out here. But by the time we get to Saturday, next weekend, triple digits are coming back. So there is your early heads up on that. You're going to see this again in the 7-day. But I wanted to start with it in my time with you because I think it's the most important part of this forecast is to start getting ready for a change. All right, back to the 4th of July. Look at the clouds already building in. That's our vantage point from the top of the Mark Hopkins Hotel in the city. You get over towards the Tri-Valley and it's perfectly clear. You look at San Jose, it's perfectly clear. Everybody's gonna get cloudy tonight. It's just those of us that are closer to the Bay are gonna get the clouds soon enough. There'll be an issue for the fireworks. But by, you know, 11 o'clock midnight tonight, we've all got the clouds. Temperatures out there in the low 70s now, and you can watch those clouds just rebuild in the overnight hours. All right, so let me give you today's forecast for tomorrow's daytime highs. It'll be very much like we were today. That means mid 80s for inland spots. We'll be low to mid 70s for much of the Bay. And as we look across the 7-day forecast, there's that warm up that I spotlighted. I just showed you Saturday on that initial run through. Sunday is still there, and it could be longer than that.